Well, speaking of awesome, we're in at a cool store called In the 216, hanging out with Jenny and some of her amazing makers.
Yes.
Okay, and two stores, about 150 different makers slash artists are represented, correct?
Yes, absolutely. Yep, all kinds of different things.
Now, you want to mention here free parking.
Yes, Clifton parking is always free. And on Coventry Road in Cleveland Heights, there is meter parking. It is free today for everyone, so go on out.
Gotta love that. All right, we're talking to Garrett. Started out at American Greetings. And Garrett, how do you turn pieces like this, boom, 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 into art?
Oh, well, I use a lot of spray paint. Mm-hmm. And then we go a layer of color.
Gotcha.
And then we add some collage and some more transparent paints.
Uh-huh.
And more stencils and color, and becomes that.
Wow.
Yeah.
And way to repurpose old records.
Oh, yeah, it's a great idea. I love vinyl records. Mm-hmm. They're making a huge comeback. And I was like, a couple years ago, it was like an epiphany. Like, I saw other people painting on them. Why have I not done that yet?
Right.
And it's been great ever since.
And this is really cool. You took a step up and did a skateboard here?
Yeah, I do skate decks. I do canvases. I do everything. Big murals, huge wall-sized things. I do, you name it, I can do it.
Awesome. I can see a lot of these in a man cave.
Oh, totally.
Yeah, good stuff. It hit me just like that. And
yeah.
Then talk about these two.
I took a photo of the Guardians mm-hmm. on the Carnegie Bridge
right. And
the Guardians of Transportation. And then I kind of do my pop art graffiti style version of it on canvas. And
awesome. They're
kind of like a staple of Cleveland now.
Yeah,
they're like
they are.
The mascot of Cleveland, and people love it.
Yeah.
So I was like, hey, let's do it.
Awesome.
They come out cool. They come out very cool.
All right, good. I'm going to swing by you right here. All right, Jake, your family has been making hats in Cleveland since the 80s.
Yes, sir. 1984.
Wow. Making hats. So people manufactured right here. It's totally cool. And you've kicked it up a notch, little young guy. Just talk about your line.
We want to do a retail line, something mm-hmm. a little bit cooler. And, you know, we do some pretty neat stuff. We can customize the underside of the visors,
okay. The
top visor. And each hat just starts from a piece of fabric, and mm-hmm. we turn it into the final product.
Very cool. And now hats are like fashion statements. When your family first started out, they were just like functional. Now they're actually a fashion accessory.
Exactly, yeah. And we like to keep it a little bit of both, too. So our winter hats, mm-hmm. they're still very functional. They're lined with a thin silhouette lining and keep you very warm in the wintertime.
Gotta love that, especially when it's like 2 degrees outside.
Exactly.
Talk about this. This hat got a lot of attention, right? The Cleveland Browns hat. Talk about that.
I came up with that about 2 years ago just as a little joke. And it took off from there. After every game we lost, the little bit more popular those hats got.
Yeah, so now they're selling like hotcakes. We're going to check his place out. Okay, Todd Meany, a little something for you. A little Todd Meany trivia.
Yes, sir.
All right. Can you describe what's the game?
Galaga.
Very good.
Okay.
What's the game here?
That would be Pac-Man.
Oh, Pac-Man. Oh, that
yes.
One.
Very good.
I like
that.
Those are awesome.
Oh, and this one?
Super Mario Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
Well done, Super
nice.
Mario.
Christy Capel in the games.
Yes.
Yeah, Christy Capel. Clutch hitter.
You have a Duck Hunt shirt? I got another Duck Hunt.
Thanks, Kenny.